Today we are going to start with a counter. Counter. Now, this counter is one of the application of flip-flop. Counter is the one of the application of flip-flop. Now, with the help of counter, you have to count the number of pulses. Now, pulses, how you can count the pulses with the help of clock pulses? Clock pulses are there along with the flip-flop. Now, you have to count the number of clock pulses. Okay, and that one is the counter. Now, there are different types of counters. The counter may be a synchronous one or synchronous. Synchronous counter is also called as ripple counter. Now again, these synchronous and asynchronous are divided into three types: up counter, down counter and up down counter. Similarly, these also. Okay, now we will go through one after another. First one, asynchronous counter. Up counter, the clock pulses start from 0. It counts from in ascending order 0, 1, 2, 3, up to like that. This one is the up counter. Down counter counts from 7, 6, 5, 4, up to 0. Okay, getting the difference between these two? Up counter and down counter. Now with the help of up count, up and down counter, you can count the pulses in ascending order as well as in descending order. Okay, instead of counting the pulses separately, you can count the pulses in ascending order as well as in descending order with the help of up down counter. Now, which are the different flip-flops are available? B, T, SR, JK, etc. Okay, we have to design all these counters with the help of different flip-flops. Okay, now there is the IC7476 available. Okay, for JK flip-flop, you have to design the synchronous counter as well as asynchronous counter with the help of JK flip-flop. 7476 you have to use in your lab. Okay, for designing the counter. Asynchronous counter. Asynchronous up counter. When you are using the asynchronous counter, what is the difference between synchronous and asynchronous? in every case you have to apply the clock pulse, okay, because your sequential circuit you have to design with the help of flip flop is nothing but a memory element, okay, for storing the present state as well as next state, okay, next state, previous state, you have to require that flip flop, okay, for that purpose you require the clock pulse, okay, whichever I am giving to the flip flop, okay. Now this is the counter, it is nothing but your sequential circuit. Every sequential circuit you have to design with the help of flip flop, clear, okay. Now for that you have to apply clock pulses. Now as I told you in the previous lecture, the clock pulses may be the edge triggered, may be the lever triggered, okay, negative edge triggered and positive edge triggered is there, along with that positive lever triggered and negative lever triggered are there, okay, remember. Now whenever the output get changes on the negative edge of the clock pulse, it is called negative edge triggered. Output changes on the negative falling edge, that one is the negative edge triggered, okay. If the output changes on the leading edge, that one is the positive edge triggered. Output changes on the negative edge triggered, that one is the negative edge triggered, clear, okay. Now asynchronous and synchronous, there is a main difference between these two. In case of asynchronous counter, in both cases you have to apply the clock pulse, but in case of asynchronous counter you have to apply the clock pulse here initially. Externally you have to apply the clock pulse, okay. After that first flip flop, output of the first flip flop you have to give to the next one. Output of the previous flip flop you have to give to the next clock pulse, okay. That happens in your asynchronous counter. Means first time this one is active, whenever the output will receive on this queue, that output will come towards that next clock pulse and then this flip flop will active, clear, okay. Clock pulse we are applying externally. Output of the first flip flop we are giving to the next clock pulse, okay. So at a time only one flip flop can get active, okay. Pehle ye ho jayega, uske baad this one, okay. Now this is asynchronous one. Output of first flip flop given to the okay. Now in case of synchronous counter, the clock pulse you have to apply simultaneously to all the flip flops, okay. Clock pulse you have to apply simultaneously to all the flip flops. In case of asynchronous, output of the first flip flop we are giving to the next clock pulse. Here we are applying the clock pulse simultaneously to all the flip flops, okay, so that they can work at a time. Here the second flip flop has to wait for the previous output, okay. After that the second will active, clear. That one is the first basic difference. Later on we will see the next difference. Now to avoid the mishap and sudden power off is there, we have to apply that clear and preset terminal, okay. You have to give that one to the logic one every time, okay. Now as I told you, the T flip flop, what is here, T is there, okay. Now JK, how you can convert JK? By connecting J and K with the same terminal, okay. So it is converted into flip flop. T is nothing but your toggle flip flop. Okay, T is the toggle flip flop having J and K same value. D flip flop mein you have to connect J and K through NOT gate. Remember? Okay, now whenever I am applying here one, this one is the set. Okay, or this one is the toggle set. In case of JK flip flop, what is the toggle set? When you are applying J and K equals to 1, 1, truth table of JK is 0, 0, no change. Okay, 0, 1, set, no, reset. 1, 0, set. And 1, 1 is the toggle set. Toggle set means what? Whenever the value of Q is 0, okay, value of Q is 0, after certain duration, it becomes 1. After again some duration, it becomes 0. That one is the toggle state. Understood? Okay, now, how many flip-flops are there? Two flip-flops are there. How many bits you can store? With the help of single flip-flop, you can store one bit only. One bit is for one flip-flop. Okay, with the help of one flip-flop, you can store one bit only. As I am utilizing two flip-flops, you can store two bits with the help of two flip-flops. Clear? Okay, now as there are two flip-flops, how many possible combinations are there? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1 is there. Okay, these are the four combinations available. Or these are the states. These are the four combinations with the help of 0 and 1. Okay. Now, as I told you, that one is the negative edge triggered. Negative output of the flip-flop will change on the negative edge of the clock pulse. Okay. Initially, both are the reset. Okay. Initially, both flip-flops are reset. Here, observe. Output of first one we are giving to the next clock pulse. Okay, we are giving output of first flip flop to the next clock pulse. Okay, so it is your, which type of flip flop? It is a synchronous one. Clear? Output we are giving to the next clock pulse, so it is a synchronous one. As I am giving Q of the previous one to the next clock pulse. Okay, so it is your up counter. When I am giving Q of the previous one to the next clock pulse, it is called up counter. When I am giving Q bar of the previous one to the next clock pulse, it is called down counter. Okay, so that is the difference between up and down counter. Okay. Clear? When I am applying Q to the next one, it is acting as an up counter. When I am applying Q bar to the next clock pulse, it is down counter. Okay? Now, in both cases, up and down counter, okay, even though it is down counter or up counter, in both cases you have to take the output from the Q only. Clear? Now, initially, QA and QB. This one is the MSB and this one is the LSB. Lower significant and most significant. QA and QB are both are reset states. Okay. Whenever I am applying the clock pulse to the first flip flop. Okay. Whenever I am applying the clock pulse to the first flip flop at the negative edge of the first clock pulse. Okay. At the negative edge of the first clock pulse, the output becomes 1. Okay. At the negative edge of the first clock pulse, the output becomes 1, which is applied to the next one. Kisko? B ko jayega. QB is MSB and QA is LSB. Okay. This one moves to the next clock pulse. That time, the B flip flop remains inactive. So the value of QB is 0 only. Okay. Next time, second clock pulse, at the end of second clock pulse, this one becomes active. Okay. So here, the value of this becomes 1 and this one is 0. Like that, at the end of third one, it is 0, 0. And again, it moves to the 0, 0. 1, 1 ke baad 0, 0. Means, this is your 0 state, this first state, this is your second state, third state is 0 state. Okay, as I am giving here out Q of the previous one to the next clock pulse. Okay, Q of the previous to the next clock pulse. 0, 1, 2, 3. It counts in up direction or ascending order. Getting that one is the up counter. Reverse of that one. When I am giving here Q. A bar of the first one to the next clock pulse, that one is acting as a down counter. Understood? Okay. Now, this is about your 2-bit up counter or synchronous counter. Okay. Now, if you have to draw the down counter, asynchronous counter, how you can draw it? Asynchronous counter. As there are 3 bits, how many flip-flop you require? 3 flip-flop, okay? Any flip-flop you can use. Suppose this one is JK. Along with that J and K, there are this one is the preset. This one is Leo. Okay. Now, down counter QC, QB, QA. As it is your down counter, which one is the first state? 3 bits are there. How many possible states are available? There are 8 possible states. 2 raised to 3. Okay? 8 possible states are there. And as we are counting from 0, it is 0 to 7 states. Okay? We are using that down counter. So the first state is, okay? It counts in descending order. So, this one is the first state, then six, five, four, three, two, one, zero. Okay? If you have the clear idea related to that one, you can draw the state diagram initially. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. First state, next state is 6, then 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Again after 0, you will get 7 state. Okay, that one is the state diagram. State diagram of 3 bits down. Understood? In case of down counter, your first state is 7 and you have to move up to 0. After 0, again it will count 7 states. Again, repeat the loop. Okay? According to that, you have to prepare the truth table for it. Clear? Understood all of you? Now, as it is your down counter, which changes we have to do here? Externally, you have to apply the clock pulse here. Okay? Q bar of the first one, you have to give to input to the next clock pulse. QB bar you have to give to the next clock pulse. Okay, now here every time you have to take the output from clear. Now with the help of PB, how many states you can count? 7, 8 states you can count. 0 to 7. Okay. These are 8 states are there. Okay. Suppose I have to count 5 states out of these 8 states. Is it possible? Yes or no? It is possible. Now, for that, which changes we have to do? Okay, if I have to count 5 states out of 8 states, it is called divide by n. Divide by n counter. Means, mujhe 5 state count karne hai, so it is called divide by 5 counter. Okay? Or, it is also modulo 5 counter. Okay? If I have to count 5 states with the help of 2 flip-flop, is it possible to count 5 states? No, because with the help of 2 flip-flop, you can count only 4 states. Okay? As I have to count 5 states, minimum I require 3 flip-flop for that. Okay, with the help of 3 flip-flops, you can count 8 states. Out of these 8 states, I have to count 5 states. Okay, so it is also called divide by 5 counter or modulo 5 counter. Clear? That modulo 5 is also along with that, synchronous is also called ripple counter. The question is like that, design the mod 5 counter, ripple counter. You have to draw all these truth table, state diagram along with the excitation table or the circuit diagram. Okay? Now, mod 5 counter you have to design with the help of mod 5. Again, QC, QB, QA. This is the state diagram. Out of that one, how we can draw this one? Mod 5. is the mod 5. Again after that, move towards the first one. Okay, that one is the mod 5. Clear up to this one? State diagram of mod 5 counter. Now, come towards that one. QC, QB and QA is there. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. Okay? जीरो 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 मॉड फाइव डिजाइन करना है. सो दिस वन इज द वैलिड स्टेट. वन वैलिड स्टेट, टू, थ्री, फोर, अप टू दिस वन फाइव स्टेट्स आर वैलिड. आफ्टर दैट ऑल दीज आर इनवैलिड स्टेट. ओके, सो दैट वी हैव टू डिजाइन द के मैप फॉर इट. वाई इक्वल्स टू, these are the input QC, QB and QA. Okay, with the help of that QC, QB and QA, 3 bits are there. Okay, 1, 1, 0. By making the grouping of it, you will get 0001110001. This is QB bar QA bar, QB bar QA bar plus QC bar. Okay, QB bar QA bar for this one, and this one is the QC bar. That is the value of Y. Valid state, five states are there. For that we are designing the K map and find out the expression for it. Okay, now as I told you, for designing the five state mod five counter, you require minimum three flip flops. Okay, JK, there is a preset terminal. Now, as it is your up counter, output of first one Q, you have to give to the next clock pulse. Output of first one, previous one, you have to give to the next clock pulse. Okay? Always you have to take the output from QB and QC only. These are output pins. Okay, along with that, J and K, you have to connect to the logic 1. Now, with the help of that one, you can count 8 states. Okay, 3 flip-flops are available. With the help of 3 flip-flops, you can count 8 states. And I have to count only 5 states out of these 8 states. Okay, so for the valid state, I find out the expression for it. okay, y equals to qa bar plus qc bar. Okay, along with these terminals, there is another one terminal as well. Which one is that one? This one is Clio. Okay, this one is Clio. Now, QB bar, QA bar. And QC bar. Okay, with the help of three flip-flops, you can count 8 states. For the valid states, I find out the expression QB bar, QA bar plus QC bar. For that, we draw that circuit here. Due to that, it will count up to 5 states. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And after this 4th or 5th state, it will move towards again. It moves towards the 5th one or 6th state for a particular duration of time. Okay, for a particular duration of time, it moves towards the 6th state. Okay, but after that, it will remember that nahi, that one is the mod 5 counter. So that I have to clear that content, and again I have to move start it from the 0th state. Okay, so that particular duration, jo 5th state se 6th state pe jata hai, that one is the propagation delay. Okay, after that propagation delay, it again moves towards the first state, that is the 0 state, and again starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4 field say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that, this one is the mod 5 counter. After the 5th state, you have to clear the contents of the flip-flop, and again it starts from the 0 to 4 state. Clear? That one is the mod 5 counter or divide by 5 counter. Okay, like that you have to divide mod 7. For that, what you have to do? You have to, how many states are there? There are 7 states, 0 to 6. Okay, these are also becomes valid state, and this one is the invalid state. Again, for that you have to the K math, and from that again you have to find out the expression for it. Okay, this one. Okay, and jo expression yaha pe aata hai, with the help of that one, you have to clear the contents of the flip flop. So it will work as a mod 7 counter. Clear? क्या ना है. नेक्स्ट वन इज द अप डाउन काउंटर. नाउ वी सॉ द अप काउंटर एंड डाउन काउंटर सेपरेटली. नाउ हाउ यू कैन कंबाइन अप एंड डाउन काउंटर इन अ सिंगल सर्किट. फॉर दैट वी हैव टू रिक्वायर वन ऑफ द अगेन वी हैव टू एड द कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट इन टू इट. ओके सो देयर इज अ मोड कंट्रोल. ओके मोड कंट्रोल इज देयर वन एक्स्ट्रा टर्मिनल यू हैव टू टेक. ओके दैट मोड कंट्रोल मे बी जीरो और वन. ओके नाउ एम इज देयर क्यू बी क्यू एंड क्यू बार अलॉन्ग विद दैट आउटपुट वाई इज देयर 0001 1011 अगेन 0001 1011 1011 दीज आर द पॉसिबल कॉम्बिनेशन आर देयर एंड हियर फॉर दीज एम मे बी जीरो एम मे बी वन. ओके सो दैट when m equals to 0 when m equals to 0 it is acting as a up counter. When m equals to 1 it is acting as a down counter. From that one you have to design again k map for m q q bar. Okay you have to insert these values into it 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 1. From that you will get the value here expression y equals to m bar q plus m q bar. Okay from that one with the help of k map you will get the expression m bar q. Okay m bar q and m q bar. Okay for acting as a up counter circuit for up and down counter. Okay two flip flops are there. Okay with the help of two flip flops you can count four states. Okay now here you have to count 0 0 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 again you have to count 1 1 1 0 1 0 1 and 0 0. Both combinations you have to verify in this one. Okay Listen, when value of n equals to 0, value of m equals to 0, okay, here you will get 1, m ki value 0 hai, so you will get here 1, okay, 1 hai, so it will connect it to the first and third AND gate. This terminal is connected to the first and third AND gate. Okay. Whenever I am giving the value of m equals to 0, it comes here 1. So, your first and third having the value, one of the terminal having value 1 and the whichever the value comes at the Q of every flip-flop, it comes here. Okay. ANDing of these two, it is available here. Okay अगर जीरो है तो भी जीरो वैल्यू आएगी, वन वन है तो वन आएगी. अकॉर्डिंग टू द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दैट मोड कंट्रोल एंड हिस क्यू दैट कंटेंट इज अपियर एट द आउटपुट साइड ऑफ द फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड एंड गेट. ओके, सो दैट कंटेंट कम टूवर्ड्स द और गेट एट दैट टाइम हिस वन इज जीरो. ओके, मैंने यहाँ पे वन दिया. अप काउंटर का अप काउंटर वर्क करना है हमें. व्हेन मोड कंट्रोल इक्वल्स टू जीरो, ओके, इट बिकम्स वन. दैट टाइम योर सेकेंड एंड फोर्थ आर इनएक्टिव. ओके, बिकॉज इट हैज द कंटेंट जीरो. ओके, जीरो के साथ कॉम्बिनेशन एंड का वन ऑफ द टर्मिनल इज जीरो, सो यू विल गेट जीरो ओनली. ओके, यहाँ पे धीस एंड धीस ये इनएक्टिव रहेगा. द कंटेंट विच एवर इज अवेलेबल ऑन द क्यू ऑफ ऑल द फ्लिप फ्लॉप कम टूवर्ड्स दिस फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड वन. ओके, सो एंडिंग ऑफ दिस टू कम्स हियर एंड यू विल गेट टू द और आउटपुट ऑफ द और गेट. ओके, यहाँ पे अभी मुझे आउटपुट ऑफ द और गेट कहाँ पे मैंने दिया है, टू द नेक्स्ट क्लॉक पल्स. मीन्स इनडायरेक्टली द कंटेंट्स ऑफ क्यू ऑफ द प्रीवियस फ्लिप फ्लॉप यू आर गिविंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्लॉक पल्स हियर. Contents of Q given to the next clock pulse, that one is acting as up counter. Whenever I am giving Q of the previous one to the next clock pulse, it is acting as the up counter. Whenever I am giving Q bar of the previous one to the next clock pulse, it is acting as a down counter. Okay? Whenever I am giving here now zero, first and third will active, so the content Q of the previous one comes towards this one, and this content ultimately reach up to the next clock pulse and it is acting as a up counter. Okay, whenever I am giving ultimately it becomes zero, that time these are inactive ones and these are active ones because it has one at this second and fourth. So the Q bar contents of the previous clock pulse of previous flip flop come towards the next clock pulse. So it is acting as a down counter. Okay? And this one is up and down counter in a single circuit. When m equals to 0, it is acting as a up counter. When m equals to 1, it is acting as a down counter. Here, your first and third AND gate is active. And here, second and fourth AND gate is active. Clear? Understood? All of you? Up and down counter in a single circuit. Now you have to implement that one, all these mod 5, mod 7, mod 11, mod 3 bit up down counter, 2 bit up down counter in your practical slot with the help of 7476 IC. Okay, 7476 IC is nothing but JK flip flop. Okay, in a single IC there are two flip flops. Every time you have to connect that JK clear and preset to the logic 0. If you are using that mod